Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first video, hi, I'm Elena, and this is The Organized Money, where we talk about planning life and managing money. In today's video, we are going to be doing a weekly functional plan with me. I'm going to be planning in my life planner, which is an hourly planner that I created, and also planning out my to-do list in my vertical happy planner big. So this is how I set up my entire week, and let's go ahead and get started. So I'm starting off by adding in some flower stickers. This is the flower sticker book from Happy Planner. It's one of my favorite sticker books that they have, and I love to use these flowers to kind of add along my sidebars and in the corners of my planner so they don't take up too much space. I still have plenty of room to write, and I still am able to decorate as well. With me being a functional planner, a lot of times I had not put in any stickers in the past, but I did miss them. So now I try my best to use stickers along the side and at the very top of my planner so that I can have the best of both worlds. The next thing that I'm going to do is lay down some of my icon stickers. We are planning on taking a trip this week, so I'm going to mark that off with a little luggage bag. And then I also have my colorful box stickers in which I will highlight any events that I have for this particular week. So we are planning on being out of town toward the end of the week, and I'm just so used to writing in my AM routines. I didn't even realize that I had wrote it in at the end of the week as well. I'm gonna end up whiting those out later on. But I usually do the first three things at the beginning of every morning, which is my AM routine, my workout, and then my planner routine. So I have a list of things that I do within my AM routine, which is like my prayer, my meditation, and a bunch of different things that I will keep on habit trackers. And then with my workout, usually I will take 30 minutes to do some type of YouTube video where I am working out with that video, and then I jump into my planner routine, get my coffee, and then I will start my day. So usually on a Sunday, I will fully plan out Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. And then around Tuesday or Wednesday, I will fully plan out Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. That way I can really be sure that I am planning accurately. However, this week we're actually going out of town on a Thursday. So I'm going to fully plan out Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. And then I'm going to decorate more on this particular spread because I can. Usually I'm not able to decorate as much as I like to because I have so many plans and so many different things going on. But this week, because I am going out of town, I can decorate a little bit more because I won't need the space to write in all of the details. So this week we are actually heading off to Baltimore. We're going to visit my husband's family who is out there. We haven't seen them since before the pandemic, so we are really, really excited about that. And I really underestimated the space that I have here. So as you can see, my inn looked really crazy. So I ended up whiting it out, putting some stickers over that, and then writing it in at the bottom here, and it came out a little bit better. And that's pretty much going to be it for this spread. And actually Saturday is my 11th wedding anniversary. So while we're out there, we're also going to take some time out to celebrate. I'm just going to mark that off here. And that's going to be it for this spread. So with my planners, I have been using my main planner, as in my hourly planner. This is where I'm keeping track on an hourly basis of every single thing that I'm doing. I always write in all of my plans with a black pen, and then afterwards, as the day is going on, I will use a red pen in order to mark off different things that happened or didn't happen. And I do have my habit tracker right there that you can see. That's where I mark off all the things for my morning routine. The next planner that I am going to decorate is my to-do list planner. So this is something that I am trying out. In the previous months, I have had a business planner and a personal planner in which I will keep track of all of my home duties and my health. So health, home, business have all been in two separate planners, but I wanted to try and combine them. This is just me testing out to see if it's going to work for me. I might end up splitting it back up, but I always like to try and test different things out to see how I like it. So previously, this was my personal planner, I believe, but now I am trying to see if it's going to work as a full to-do list planner. I like to decorate it using the exact same colors or theme that I did with my catch-all planner. So for this week, we are still using the flowers. And then I'm going to separate it based on the different subjects. So since I have home and then I have work and I also have my business, I'm going to label those sections within each one of the boxes. And then that way I can kind of stay on top of all of the to-dos that I have for a particular day in one planner. So that's the whole idea behind it, so that I don't have to keep flipping back and forth between my planners. I'm trying to see if I have one planner that I can kind of list out my entire schedule and have all of the different things that I need to do by hour. And then I have another planner in which I can list out all of the to-dos, and then that way I have everything in one spot. So we're gonna see how this works out. Of course, I'm gonna try it for the entire month of April. If it works, then I'll keep it. If not, then I can always switch back. So I'm just adding in all of the different things that I need to do. The very first area is the organized money. This is me writing in all of the things I need to do for my business. The second area is work, which is my church, where I'm just writing in all the things I need to do for my church. As you guys know, I'm the CFO of my church, so I will keep track of all of the to-dos that I need to do for that there. And then the bottom section is my home. So that's me keeping track of the different things that I want to clean, eat. All of that will be in that section there. I love this method because I'm able to kind of brain dump here. With my catch-all planner, I am really trying to stick to what I'm actually going to be able to get done. But with this planner, it gives me room to kind of just write down anything that I want to do. It's one big brain dump. Even if I can't get to it all, I love having a spot where I can just leave everything that I would like to do in each particular area on a sheet of paper, on a page somewhere. So that's how I have been using this. I used it last week and I did enjoy it. So we're going to try it out again this week. Loving this spread, loving my catch-all planner. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video and I will see you all in my next one. Until then, keep organizing your life so that you can achieve your dreams. Bye guys.